feathers in wild pheasant
birding at Mangar, a beautiful valley and sacred grove hill forest next to Mangar village on Delhi Haryana border. It is one of the last remaining natural tropical forests in Aravali range. It has more than 30 native tree species thriving along with the 100 plus native shrubs and herbs, all of which provide shelter to the wildlife, animals and rare birds. Once we cross the Mangar village towards Baba temple, a village pond can grab anyone's attention during monsoon. One can easily spot the colonies of bayas. Bayas, they are best known for the elaborately woven nest. Their colonies are up to 20 to 30 nests and close to the source of food, nesting materials and water. The nests are woven with paddy leaves and rough grasses and are often built from thorny acacia or palm trees hanging over open water. The male are almost solely in charge of nest building and took almost 8 days to reach intermediate stage of nest building called helmet stage. When the nests are partially built, males begins to display to passing females by flapping their wings and calling while hanging from their nest. After inspection, females accept male signal. Once they pair, the male goes on to complete the nest by adding the entrance tunnel. The whole cycle of building the nest took almost 18 days and their female partner joined them in giving the finishing touch, particularly on the interiors, just like the human beings. You can spot water hen, coot and mynas on the pond itself. On opposite side of this small pond, you can spot blue chickpea eaters and blue tail bee eaters. As we move towards Baba temple, which is approximately 2 kilometers from Mangar village, the ancient temple provides the status of sacred groves of Mangar Bani. According to the local, the Baba Gudariya Das protect this bani and punishes anyone who damages this forest. Bird watching is one of the most reliable boost to your mental and physical well-being. Nothing is better than wandering in the nature and observing the world's nice creature, the bird. Unfortunately, many birds are endangered nowadays, and it's our common responsibilities to protect them and their habitat. Every Sunday, dedicated groups of bird watchers make their way to Mangar Bani, armed with their binoculars and cameras. These groups spend hours in the jungle watching the beautiful birds. Not only in the monsoon, place is active with birds throughout the year. During the monsoon, the entire valley is full of birds call, such as bugle, quail, cuckoos, shrikes, etc. The doctor of the tree, woodpecker, are on his job, and the nightjar, after their night shift, they are resting on the branches. They are hard to find as they are completely camouflaged with the environment. The nine-colored bird, Indian pitta, started coming here for nest building. I know Indian pitta, nightjar and some other birds at Mangar always do an excellent job of grabbing everyone's attention. But I believe and expect birders naturally want to save more of environment and protect their habitat. Like other forests, Mangar is also home of many birds. Asian brown flycatchers, red-breasted flycatchers, tiger flycatchers, canary stick, coppersmith barbet, many warblers such as palethrid warblers, sulfur-bellied warbler, rose-ring and plump-headed parakeet. On the way to Damdama Lake from Mangar, one can spot white-capped bunting, crested bunting, long-tailed shrike, grey-throated martin, Indian roder, European roder during migration, and many birds. Like the bunny area, the outskirts of Mangar is full of happening places. Some of the places are dry forest and some are very green patches. Both places attract variety of the birds. Some of them are very rare, such as song thrush, some of them are very colorful, orange-headed thrush, black-throated thrush, and yellow beauty martial ayuras, grey-headed candy flycatcher, black-headed cuckoo shrike, white-bellied drongo, the exclusive eastern orphan warbler, uncommon Brooks leaf warbler, common roach finch, Indian golden oriole, black red start, common wood shrike, lesser white throat, black drongo, etc. The Indian paradise flycatcher, they are also quite active during the breeding season and do nesting in Aravali range. With all the safer measure and long distance, I could able to film the nest of red-vented bulbul with 3 chicks. It is amazed to see how parents take care of their each kids. The white-throated fan tail can easily gain your attention while fanning their tail and melodious call. The yellow-crowned woodpecker also called as Maratha's woodpecker, will tweak in between your birding and shows his presence. Apart from the perching and grounded bird, one can see raptors and vultures during the daytimes. Some of them are short-toed snake eagle, red-headed vulture, Egyptian vulture, etc. Once you are planning to visit Mangar for bird watching, kindly do ensure the nature and the birds come first. Do not spoil the nature and disturb the bird habitat. The place like Mangar is a heaven in earth, especially when it's surrounded by concrete jungle of Gurgaon, Faridabad, or a heavy traffic of Delhi NCR. Like every other open spaces in the NCR, Mangar Bani too is under the threat of being developed into a concrete jungle. I hope you like my videos. For more video, kindly subscribe the channel.